Proverbs chapter number 31. All right, Proverbs chapter number 31, verse number 10 says, who can find a virtuous woman, for her price is far above rubies? Now, we know that Solomon wrote Proverbs, and I would have to add this, that if there's anybody that understands anything concerning women, I would hope Solomon figured it out. He certainly had enough studying. He should have been able to resolve all issues on that class. Now, virtuous really means pure. Pure. Honest. Sincere. Dedicated. A virtuous woman. A woman that can be depended upon, counted on, to do those things that she has responsibility to. And the Bible here is saying, if you had to purchase this kind of an individual, you would not have enough money in your bank account to make that purchase. Her cost is above any amount of money you can come up with. And so that's why he says, for her price is far, and look at the word far, above rubies. Rubies being a very, very precious and expensive jewel of its time. It still is. All right, then he says in verse number 11, he says, the heart of a husband does safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. So he says, the heart of a husband, his knowledge, his mind concerning his wife, he does not have any worries, any concerns. He is confident that he's married to a good one, that he has a good one. Then it talks about he safely trusts in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. Spoil is other women. He is so tuned to her and so in love with her because of her virtuousness in the relationship that he ain't even thinking about another woman. So Sister Betty comes by, and she has on a tight skirt, too tight for blood to circulate. She has on no blouse. Her breast is poking folk in the forehead. She's switching, knocking folk down with her hips swaying from side to side. Her bottom is bouncing like jelly. She's very well shaped. Very attractive in her face, long hair, pretty, however you like it. But this man simply ignores her. Because everything I got is at home. I don't need nothing outside of what I got at home. This is the kind of relationship that the woman, now remember that the focus is on the woman, not on the man. But the woman brings to the table when she comes with her arsenal. Now if she comes attitudinal, she comes with a bad disposition, she comes with a toe-to-toe mentality, she will not fit this format. Sister One Tooth Nancy, cockeyed, breath stink, got your man. He ain't fooling with no woman that want to be as much of a man as he is. He wants something soft and gentle that he can cuddle with. Something that, and I said this away, something that makes him feel like he is king of the hill when he come home. So the focus is on the woman, her ability cause a man to feel that, to know that. Therefore, she gets listed as being virtuous. Now, there's some things that she has to do in order to achieve that. You know, and you know, in this day, people will say, well, you know, you need to put on something nice when you come home and fix your hair. I'm telling you, man, you could look like a rag mop if you done your job. Papa happy when he get back.
Hello.
Glad to come home. Been out there fighting the lions, tigers, and bears, and he gonna come home, and somebody got some warm bath water for him. Say, so go on and soak yourself, honey, and when you get done, I'll have the plate on the table. You know, it's man stupid stuff, but it works. And she's saying, I ain't no slave. That's why you can't be virtuous.
Amen.
That's why you can't be virtuous. Must be one man in the house. The rest of them scared. And then the women ain't about to say something. So, he must not be married. The non-married folk always get in on the married conversations. All right, verse number 2 says what? She will. I mean, verse number 12. I'm sorry. Verse number 12. I saw the 2. I didn't see the rest of them. Verse number 12. She will do him good and not evil all the days of, not his life, her life. All the days of her life, he can count on her daily. He can count on her, and he don't have to worry about that. If he puts something in her possession to do, if he tell her something, she gonna follow through like he said. Honey, it's 12 o'clock. You don't need to be going outside. You don't tell me what to do, I'm grown. Lord have mercy. 12 o'clock midnight, where you going? 10:30 at night, what you doing talking about you getting up, going out? Lord have mercy. Y'all know y'all do that in the church. Y'all ought to cut it out.
Amen.
Y'all ought to cut it out. It says what? Verse 12. She will do him good. I don't see nothing that has nothing to do with what he going to do. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. She gonna do. Yes, sir.
So is it the man that wins the woman, or the woman that wins
the
man?
The woman wins the man. The woman wins the man and tie him down. Amen. Through her submissiveness and her desires to please him, she wins him. But through her desires to be an independent working woman of the world, she loses. Yes, sir.
I just want to make sure we make it plain. This is just to marry women, not women that's looking for that husband playing house, shacking up, doing all kind of stuff outside of
house. This works for any woman. Now, if the man dumb enough to run around with her and he ain't married to her, if she dumb enough to do all of that and not be married to him, because if something happened to him, she ain't getting nothing out the pot, that's on her. But this works.
Amen.
I can't take away the fact that this works.
So she can be virtuous without being married.
Yes.
Well, that's one of my questions.
She can be.
Right. That's what
most women are until they get married.
What you said though?
This is the truth. Most women are dedicated to that man until she put the ring on, and then she become a he in the relationship.